Okay, we are here again today with Mr. Zainal, Madam Hana and myself. We are getting to know the Total Station. How to set up this Total Station. Okay, and how to take a reading. Okay, so now we want to mark our control station. So since this is a soft ground, we have to use a wooden peg. Okay. Okay, so you can use this as a marking to mark your TBM as well as your control station. As I've mentioned before, your TBM can also be one of your control station. Okay, so mark it very precisely like that, so that it is a temporarily permanent point, but it doesn't disturb all the other activities that's going on around here. Alright, so to set up your total station, we are going to get the tripod. Okay, so you can see that. That's the point, right? So, you take the tripod. Okay, and then you can spread the legs. And then just slightly push the pointy part into the ground. If it is not on the soft ground, you just simply put it firmly like that. Okay, perhaps like this one, you can put like in between it, so it doesn't move, yeah? Okay, so now, okay, you unscrew this screw part. You unscrew this one halfway. Okay, and then pick up, make it higher. Okay, so this is why we have more people in your survey party, so that we can cooperate with each other. So once you know that your tripod is according to the height that you want, you take the total station and you screw over there, so that it is fixed onto the tripod and it is stable. Yeah, until you have screwed it, never let go of the tri-batch. This is what we call a tri-batch. Okay, this is a tri-batch. So never let it go until it is screwed firmly here. Okay, so now what we want to do is to level up the total station, because we want to make sure that the bubble over there is in the middle of the circle. But first, we have to make sure that the instrument, this instrument, the middle part of the instrument here, this is the guide, the middle part of it perfectly aligned with the point. Because for setting up total station or any other equipment that has a tri-batch like this, alright, so you have to make sure that it is set up on a point, on a particular point. Not like auto level. For auto level, we can set up anywhere. Okay? Okay, so first thing first. Alright, so first thing first. You use your foot as a guide. You just put your foot over there close to the point, and you observe over here this part of the observation point. Okay, this is where it enables you to see the middle part of the instrument, and this part would view down there. Okay, so what you do is you put your eyes here, make sure you can see the target, the ground clearly. Then one foot is fixed. Okay, one foot is fixed. The other two, you see Madam Hana's hands. Okay, she will lift it up. Lift up both legs. Okay, and with a guide from this viewer, she will put the middle of the instrument onto the nail, onto the picket. Okay, so you see, this is how the view will look like. So what do you want to target is that the middle part of the circle is exactly onto the point. Okay, so from there, if I zoom out, then I want to view over there. Even though now the centering of your equipment is almost onto the nail, but we can start to adjust the centering of the bubble, okay, to the middle of the circle. So you have to use the method of tripod legs, whereby you have to choose one of the tripod legs to make it higher or lower, then it will make the bubble go there. Okay, let's see the example. Yeah, so over here we are adjusting that particular legs, right? So look at the bubble. Okay, we want to make it higher because we want the bubble to go the other direction. Now we change to this leg. Okay, see at the bubble, down, down, down. Okay, almost there. Okay, perfectly there. So now we have to observe again onto the dry batch. Okay. Now the situation is like that, so we can adjust a little bit by a little bit. Okay, what we do is that the method is observe. While observing, you unscrew halfway. Okay, and then you see how we adjust the trebatch. It's just forward, back, left or right, just to make sure that the crosshair perfectly onto the center of the equipment. So now this is the equipment and this is the bubble. Okay, and then here's the point perfectly in the middle. So as for the bubble, we can adjust a little bit by the screw. Okay, so it looks like that. Oh, perfect. Nice. Okay, so we always double check in the tri-batch there, done, and on the bubble, done. Okay, so on to a total station. We have another bubble, which is a long bubble. So just now it was the round bubble, now this is the long bubble. Okay, so how you do it is you choose, okay, you choose one side. Okay, you see how this align, yeah? So this bubble align with these two screw. Okay, so you will have to adjust the bubble, okay, until it is in the middle. Okay, done. Now move to the next part. Just now it was here, right? It was here, now it is here. Okay, again adjust these two bubble alongside this bubble. Okay, done. Okay, the last part, because there's the tri-batch is in triangle, so we have to do three parts. The last part. Done. Okay, so now we can use this total station for the observation. Right? So you have to, okay, focus on the target, which should be your prism or your mini prism. Right.
Right, so this is our total station. Okay, mainly we have three parts of total station. That is the handle, the body and also the tri-batch. Okay, so if you can see over here, this is the handle whereby you can hold the total station by using this handle. Okay, so at the body part of the total station, we have our telescope. Okay, so this is our telescope. This is the eyepiece over here. You can see the eyepiece, and we have a screw over here to focus the crosshair of the view. And this will be to focus your view to your target. Okay. Then we have our clamp over here. Okay. So this clamp is for you to adjust. Okay, for you to adjust the telescope. So we have two clamps over here. So one will be the slow motion and one will be the clamp. Okay. So once you clamp the vertical screw, okay, so you cannot turn your telescope. Okay, so it is stopped over there. What you can do is you can use this slow motion screw to adjust your telescope vertically. Then we have our horizontal clamp over here. So this is the clamp. Once you clamp the horizontal clamp, you cannot turn your total station horizontally, right? And this is the slow motion screw, so you can adjust it slowly in the horizontal plane. So please make sure when you're using the total station, the clamp is unclamped so that you can adjust it properly. This is the interface of your total station. You can see over here, this total station have two interfaces. Some of the total station only have one interface. Okay. This is the battery. Alright. This is the battery compartment. Okay. Alright. Over here you can see a line. Okay. This is the indicator to show the height of your instrument. So if you want to measure the instrument height, you're going to use the measurement tape and measure from here, from this indicator to the ground. Okay. So this is the plumet, okay, whereby you can see from this plumet, okay, you can see the ticket on the ground, right? So you can focus by using this screw. Then you have your horizontal bubble over here. This is your horizontal bubble for you to adjust the setting. And you also have another bubble over here. This is the circular bubble, okay? And for the tri-batch part, you have the foot screw. You have three foot screws. Okay, this is to adjust your circular bubble, right? And this is the clamp for your tri-batch, right? And this is the screw for you to screw your total station to your tripod. Okay, sorry, this is your collimator. Okay, this is the collimator. Okay, this help you to target to your prism. Okay, for a total station, we have two collimators. Okay, because we can turn our telescope, so we have two collimators. For an outer level, we only have one collimator on top.
Right, so now we are going to show you how to observe and get a reading from this point to that point over there. Okay, we have set up a prism, which is the function should be a reflector, whereby the signal laser transmitted from this equipment, okay, will go to that particular prism. The signal transmitted from this total station will go to that direction, okay, wherever that we are targeting. So we are going to target to the prism, then it will be reflected back by the prism, and it will reach back to the equipment, and it will calculate the measurements of distance. There are three distances basically: horizontal, vertical and slope distance. As well as we are going to be able to set the bearing for this particular line, okay, and we can key into this equipment. Alright, so what you do is unclamp first both direction, vertical and horizontal, so make sure they are free, and this also free. Alright, and then you put your eyes on the target here. Alright, so it's either on top or at the bottom, it doesn't matter. Because both of them are pointing towards that direction, so you just target. Actually, within here, if you put your eyes closely here, you can see like a upside down triangle. Okay, it is white in color. So what you want to do is to target that white triangle into the prism as best as you can. Okay, so now I have targeted it there. Now I can clamp. Clamp, not the slow motion, the clamp. So I want to lock the position. Okay, so I have clamped horizontal and vertical. Okay, so now I can move it slow motion by using this slow motion screw. But then I have to observe first. to confirm that the view is within there. So when I observe, I can use both of these focus for target and the focus for your crosshair to make it as clear as possible. Okay, so if you see here, through here, you can see that the target is not actually over there, yeah? Okay, so my target is like that only. So I have to make sure that it is perfectly in the middle of the prism. So this is where I can use this slow motion screw. Okay, to move the observation point to the middle of the prism. Right, so this is the view that I want. So now it is set, the line is set, then we want to enter the starting bearing or the reference bearing. Okay, so we switch on the equipment for this particular equipment only. Alright, the setting is like this. If you are using a different equipment, so the functionality might be different, but the concept is the same. Right, so over here we can straight away obtain the readings of the distance that was mentioned before. So over here we have the HR. This is the bearing. Okay, this one it is not correct because this one probably from before. So here SD, slope distance, is 20.128. Okay, and then HD, horizontal distance, 20.129, and vertical distance 0.383. yeah, so here is a positive, so it means that that point, the ground that we put the prism on, is slightly higher than the point that we've set up this total station. Alright, okay, so now we want to enter the starting bearing. Okay, you can obtain your starting bearing perhaps from several ways, but if you are setting up the starting bearing from your TBM, any random point, one of the way for you to start it is by referring to a compass. Alright, the one that we always use would be the magnetic compass. Alright, so the magnetic compass has already been read. Okay, so this is one of the example of a magnetic compass. So how you do it is that you will target to your prism. Okay, and then, well, you can use your total station as a guide. Right, target to the prism, and then you can observe the reading. Put your eyes in there and read the reading. Okay, there will be one crosshair that shows that would be the measurement of this line. So once you've gotten the reading of this line, for example, from my observation, this reading is, the bearing is 185 degrees. Okay, 185 degrees. So what I do is, I will want to set key in the bearing. So you want to set key in the bearing, so you press the horizontal angle set. So just now it was 185 degrees. Okay, so I key in 185 degrees 0.0 minute 0 second. Okay, and then I will double confirm the view. Okay, I have to view again, double confirm, right? It is still in the middle of the prism. Once confirmed, I will press enter. Okay, so over here you can see that the reading, the horizontal reading, or the bearing, is set to 185 degree, 0 minute and 0 second. Let's say you are continuing a traverse work from one station to another station to another station. So when you are keying in the minute and second, you just put them together. Okay, you don't have to put so many dots in between. Okay, for example, I'm continuing from this point to the next point, and I'm continuing from the next point to the other point. So let's say my bearing is 45 degree, 15 minutes and 10 seconds. So I will key in 45 degree, point, 15 minutes and 10 seconds. Okay, so once I have set it, observe again. Okay, observe, right, confirm. I press enter. So over here, I have set the line as 45 degree, 15 minutes and 10 seconds.